Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see how esters react with strong nucleophiles like hydrides and organometallic reagents. On the left, we'll talk about hydride reagents, lithium aluminum hydride, and on the right, we'll talk about organometallics. On the left, we have the reduction of an ester to an alcohol with lithium aluminum hydride. Step one is LiAlH4, and step two is water. The reaction generates two alcohol products. The ester is cleaved during the reaction. The CO bond to the OR prime group and the carbonyl carbon is broken. So one alcohol has the R group and the other alcohol has the R prime group. Let's see a mechanism. The reaction begins with attack by a hydride. This makes a tetrahedral intermediate. On our tetrahedral intermediate, we have a potential leaving group, the OR prime group. The O minus swings down and ejects the OR prime group as an alkoxide. Remember this alkoxide for later. There's plus our alkoxide. The carbonyl has been reformed as an aldehyde. Lithium aluminum hydride says, don't mind if I do, and attacks again. This forms yet another tetrahedral intermediate. At this point, we're out of leaving groups. The tetrahedral intermediate is then protonated through the additional water. And we get one of our alcohols. Now our alkoxide at the bottom also gets protonated to form our other alcohol. That gives our two alcohol products. In general, the R group containing the alcohol is normally the featured product. So this will normally be your main product. Normally, I'll put a question mark over there, but sometimes the R prime OH is more important. Whichever is bigger is typically the true product, and the other is discarded as waste. One final word on this reaction. Technically, you can do this with sodium borohydride too, but most people use lithium aluminum hydride. Let's move to the right and look at organolithium reactions with esters. They are completely identical to hydride additions. Just as we attack the ester with hydride twice, we'll attack with organolithium twice on the right. The products are shown. Again, we get two alcohols. In this case, the carbonyl carbon did not gain two hydrogens, and I can have a hard time fitting them in, but we put two hydrogens on that carbon. Now we have our double prime groups from our organolithium. For hydride reactions, we said that either alcohol product may be the intended product. For organometallic reactions, the desired product will almost always be the alcohol that picked up the R double prime groups. I mean, that's the one that we added the organometallic reagent to. So the reaction of esters with hydrides or organometallic reagents ultimately involves two nucleophilic additions and two tetrahedral intermediates. The reaction forms two alcohol products. Normally, the alcohol from the ester carbonyl is the desired product.